was born in Lagos at Mercy Hospital in Lagos. I grew up around Yaba. I know every part of Yaba. Yaba was a cosmopolitan upper middle class residence in which we had apple trees around. In fact, it was a natural thing to have apple trees around the building, and the roads were tarred. There was water in that the whole people around Yaba or in my area where I grew up, we had public water supply. I used to fetch water in front of the Yaba library. What is the Yaba library? In the night for my parents. I used to read during holidays at the Yaba College of Technology because it had very good library, a very good science library and engineering library where I used to read. And that's how I stumbled into collecting visual art. Well, in my grow-up years, the most notable part of it is that I used to play prank like every other child. Instead of going to my primary school, I would go to Babbage. And in those days, there was this scholar bus where small children will pay virtually nothing to take this bus all the way from Yaba or from Sabu from St. Agnes to Babbage. In actual fact, at that time, the Nigeria was driving on the right side, so you find that going to Lagos, you had to take Herbert Macaulay Way to Lagos, and then you take Muritala Muhammad back from Lagos, which changed later on. And there was nothing to fear. We didn't have armed robbery, we didn't have even thieves that, you know, once in a while attempted to steal anything. They were caught with bare hands. There was nothing like armed robbery. Lagos was very beautiful. I remember also that during the independence, I was carried, you know, on the shoulder by my mother, and we went along the Kata Bridge, went along the Kata, and we saw Kata Bridge was very well lit. I was then about less than 10 years of age. I was about 14 years of age when there was a coup in Nigeria in 1966, and I stood by the roadside at Herbert Macaulay Way, and for the first time, even though my family residence was not far away from the barracks, which was in front of St. Dominic's Church that I used to attend, and St. Patrick's Primary School that I attended, I never saw soldiers dressed in camouflage. And then there I was as a kid, I saw soldiers with guns pointing at, you know, everybody going by the road. And I began to wonder, what is happening? What is it? You know, that was the first time I would see soldiers dressed in camouflage. Those are some of the reminiscences of my childhood days. I've lived all my life in Lagos. Apart from attending University of Ibadan, University of Ife, Lagos has been my life. And I can tell you that Lagos remains what it was, even though the population has since ballooned. Right now, I think Lagos is about 23 million inhabitants. I think when I was growing up, Lagos would be probably about 4 or 5 million, you know, but it's ballooned. Lagos has expanded, Lagos has improved, but Lagos remains the cosmopolitan city where every Nigerian is given an opportunity to thrive. Lagos has a lot of potentials in terms of human capacity, infrastructure, in terms of, you know, various non-physical assets and resources that can be used to multiply the growth and development of Lagos, whether you are Igbo, whether you are Yoruba, whether you are Hausa. So for that, I give kudos to those who have governed Lagos. I give kudos to the managers and, you know, civil servants that are making things happen in Lagos. I give kudos to the Oba of Lagos, the various Obas that have ruled Lagos. Lagos is a beauty to behold. I have been to over 50 countries in the world. I can say that I never feel comfortable. I never feel, more at home in anywhere in the world except Lagos. Lagos is a place of beauty, a place where you are allowed to thrive. You can dream your dreams and actualize your dreams in Lagos. I give kudos to those who made this possible. Eko akete idu ogbon aromode dede ko mama ja o eko aromi sa egbelegbe ko ma siduta o pe ko we apiro ko ma siduta o pe ko we eko we o ko ma siduta o pe bebe ko sido. This is my Lagos story. Welcome. Thank you.